I have been using the Samsung Galaxy A21s as my daily driver since the beginning of this year, and it is that time of the year I need to switch to a new daily driver, which is going to be the Samsung Galaxy A22 4G, which is a whole new upgrade in most departments, and this will be the first Samsung device I have ever tested which will come with an AMOLED display and a high refresh rate. What's up guys, it's Michael. The Samsung Galaxy A22 4G comes in this new looking box like the A02 did, and it smells fresh from the store. Let's bring the unboxing up and see what we have inside the box. Opening the box, we have this paper that should be scrapped, the device itself, 15 watts power brick, earphones, USB-C cable and a SIM ejector pin. Taking off the wrap of this device, we are greeted with a 6.4-inch Infinity U90Hz AMOLED 720p display, and this is the first time Samsung is using an AMOLED display below 100,000 Naira. While I was taking off the wrap, my hands were already touching the glossy red, which I am not a fan of and will never be a fan of it, which Samsung still didn't include a case in the box for it to eliminate it, and the power button, which doubled down at the fingerprint scanner, sounds cheap, and this device doesn't weigh much. The Samsung Galaxy A22 4G comes in black, white, mint, violet, and I wanted the violet color, but black was the only available option as at the time I purchased this device. Setting up this device for the first time took about 43 seconds, which dives us right into One UI 3.1 on Android 11. The engine powering this device is the 12nm Helio G80 chipset by MediaTek, which you can also find on the Samsung Galaxy A32 4G, which I will compare both devices in a later video, which gets some additional support from the Mali G52 GPU, and I will be dropping a gaming test soon, which you will also get notified if you subscribe and turn on post notification. Here in Nigeria, we only have two storage variants, which are 4GB RAM with 64 or 128GB of internal storage, but in India, you get up to 6GB of RAM. At the rear, we have a quad camera setup that consists of a 48MP wide lens that has optical image stabilization at 1080p but doesn't record 4K, 8MP ultra wide lens, 2MP macro lens, 2MP depth lens with a 30MP wide selfie lens. For audio, we have a mono speaker alongside with a 3.5mm headphone jack. On the security side of this device, we have the side-mounted fingerprint scanner, which is decently fast with regular PIN, pattern, password and face unlock, which is less secured. Powering the Samsung Galaxy A22 4G is a 5000mAh battery paired alongside with a 15W power brick and a USB-C cable, which Samsung should stop calling a 15W power brick fast. Time for me to swap my SIM and make the Samsung Galaxy A22 4G my daily driver. If you have any thoughts, kindly drop it down in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe and get notified when I drop my gaming and review video. Share, like, and I will see you on the video showing on your screen right now.